Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch in the laws of Beirer, of separating one of the malachas, one of the actions that are prohibited to do on Shabbos. Now, we mentioned yesterday there are three conditions of which would allow Beirer, the act of separating, to be permissible on Shabbos. Number one, you're taking the good from the bad. Number two, you're using your hand or another utensil which is considered to be an extension of your hand. For example, if you're eating food and you don't want to lift out the good from the bad with your hand, you can take a fork or a spoon, just that you can't use utensils that were made for separating purposes. As we said, for example, a sieve or a perforated spoon, a serrated spoon that has holes in it where it's trying to make a separation. And number three, as we said, it has to be for immediate use, which means I'm using it for the suda, for the meal, for the eating session that I'm going to have right now. And we pointed out that the immediate use is going to be different for each and every situation based upon how much time you need to prepare the food for that meal. Now he writes the following, V'afilu b'maycholim sh'roitzim livor mashiyoichlo ato o mashiyashiro. Even when you have a situation where you have different foods that are mixed together, and they're both good, except you only want to eat one of them right now, and you want to eat one of them for later. So I'm not really separating the bad from the good, because I'm going to use that later. I just don't want to eat it right now. Nevertheless, you have to be careful to select the food that you want to eat right now, and don't select the food that you want to leave over for later. Because that which you want to eat right now is considered to be the food. That's considered to be the good. And that which you want to leave over for later, that is called the psalis, that's called the waste and the bad in this particular situation. So this is another dimension of the halacha of Beirer. Yesterday we learned that if you have two things in front of you, one is good and one is bad, meaning you don't want that thing at all. For example, if you had a salad and you don't like tomatoes, so you have lettuce and you have cucumbers and peppers and there's tomatoes in there as well, and you do not like tomatoes. So to remove the tomatoes, that would be bad. You're taking the bad from the good. So therefore, I have to take everything else, the good, and leave the bad over. Over here, we're saying, no, I have a salad, and there's tomatoes in the salad. I'm just not in the mood to eat the tomatoes right now, but I'm going to eat them later. So let me remove the tomatoes and put them off to the side, so that in an hour or so, or a half an hour, whatever it might be, I'm going to eat those. Says the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, no, in that situation, that the tomatoes, since that you do not want them right now for consumption, therefore they take on the guise of being the waste or being the bad food, and you're getting rid of what you don't want right now and you're leaving over what you do want. So you have to do it the opposite way. You have to take what you do want and leave over the bad, as we said in the previous case. Now, just in some of the notes here to give over to you some different details that apply. This all applies when it's mixtures of different types of foods. And that's even if you have large size and you have smaller sizes, which means that you have, let's say, slices of different kinds of fish or meat or various fruits. And as long as they're intermingled, the malacha applies. So let's say you have some roast and you have some barbecue and you have some chicken, even though that they're all, let's say that they're all meats and the like, all of that not going to count over here, and all of that's going to be considered a mixture, and you have to be very careful how you do it. If you have slices of apples and slices of oranges and slices of peaches, even though they're all fruits, but they're all different kinds of fruits, that's also considered picking out good from bad if you do it in the wrong way. However, if you do have the same exact fruit, it's just different sizes. For example, you have large slices of apples and you have small slices of apples. Even though that they look different in size, but they're still considered the same thing, and then there would be no prohibition of separation in that case. However, even if you have the same kind of food, but they have different qualities. For example, you have a roast, and 20% of the roast got burned, and 80% is perfectly cooked. And it's all cut up now on the plate. And the burnt piece that nobody wants to eat is together with the good piece. So to remove the burnt piece, even though it's the same piece of meat, but since that you don't want it, that's considered to be waste, that's considered to be bad, and therefore you would not be allowed to do birer in that situation of taking the bad from the good. You once again would have to take the good and remove it from the bad. Okay, we have more details coming. Stay tuned, and in Yetz Hashem, we shall continue tomorrow. Have a wonderful day.